You know what time it is. Play my damn music. Better bounce back and get the cheddar cheese. I guess yes, sir. We did have LB sweeping on the NFL show last week, going 3-0. And as I said, if he sweeps, we will do a $20 giveaway. And thank God the first person I selected was a subscriber. I always say you have to subscribe. So with that being said, let's go ahead and hit the drum roll. And the winner of the $20 giveaway is going to be Brian Lewis, 2326. Congratulations, Brian. You gave us the good vibes. You put 3-0 or 4-0. Either way, you did give us the good vibes. We appreciate your support, and I'm going to reward you with a $20 giveaway. So leave your Cash App down below. Put a period before and after it so that the algorithm does not catch on to it. Or hit me up on Twitter. I'll leave my Twitter handle down below in the description. Either way, I'm getting you your 20 bucks. We appreciate it. You gave us the good vibes, and I'm going to send you 20 bucks like I always do and always promise. All right, if this is your first time here, as you can tell, what we like to do, we love to give away money on the show. If you'd like to qualify for today's two opportunities for giveaways, all that you need to do, number one, subscribe to the channel. Hit it right now. Number two, comment below either 3-0 or 4-0, or you can put both. And then number three, like the video. We've got four plays from Mr. Dejan. We've got three from Mr. LB. And if we go 3-0, I'll do a $20 giveaway, just like we did today. If Mr. Dejan goes 4-0, I will do a $40 giveaway. If both of them sweep, we will combine the two, and we will do a $60 giveaway. I love it. I hope we can do it again. We are rolling right now. All right, like I said, we've got seven plays to go over, and we will now just introduce both of our cappers that are with us. They've been regulars with us, so if you've been with us on the show, you should be familiar. But first, we've got in the bottom left corner, Mr. LB. You can catch him on Twitter at LB_PRA_locks. He's a regular on our WNBA show. He is a high school teacher right now, teaching high school kids math, and he uses his math skills to help find the best bets out there. Welcome back to the show, LB. In the top left, we have Mr. Dejan. Catch him on Twitter at DGenalytics LLC. Again, I'll leave both of their Twitter handles down below. Mr. Dejan is from Cleveland. He's a diehard Cleveland sports fan. He's a machine operator by day, but becomes a true degenerate at night. Welcome back, Mr. Dejan, to the show. And of course, I'm your very incompetent host, Mr. Bust Your Bookie. All I do all day is try to find edges against the books, try to win money, and then send it all back to you guys in giveaways. All right, enough of that, enough of the intros. You guys are here for some plays and some of our predictions, so we're going to go ahead and jump right into them at this point. We will start with Mr. Dejan. Like I said, he's got four plays for you guys, and here's the first one we're going to talk about. It's going to be the Houston Texans. 2-0 on the year. They are going to take on the Minnesota Vikings, who are also 2-0. This game's at 12 o'clock Central Time on CBS, and we're looking at this one. We're seeing the currently the line for this, we see it as a two-point spread. It opened up at 2.5, but I think you got a little better line. Anyways, I'll let you take it from here, Mr. Dejan, what your thoughts are and what our play is on this one.
Yeah, so I really like the Vikings in this spot. The Texans, people are really high on them this year. And for good reason. I mean, it's not to love about their offense, you know, and their defense is pretty all right. But I think they're getting a little too much love. I think these Vikings also, you know, without Kirk Cousins and, you know, and now J.J. McCarthy got hurt, they were kind of getting, you know, pooped on in a better word, I guess is the best word to use. But now that they beat the 49ers and really shown that, you know, offensively, they're still a powerhouse. Sam Darnold or not, you know, he's been – turned his career around, it looks like. We'll see how that continues. But the Texans, I really haven't really had highly rated. They are a good team, but they're not what everyone thinks they are. They're still young. Stephon Diggs is, you know, he's still just Stephon. I think this is going to be a tough spot for them traveling to Minnesota. I think, especially from what we've seen, I mean, they struggled with Indianapolis, who isn't that great of a squad, and the Bears, who offensively really haven't been doing hot. I think what we're going to see here is a little upset. I think I got it at +2. I think the last I saw it was +1.5 after JJ got announced he was going to play because he was questionable all week. They're still missing Jordan Addison. But I don't think that's going to make a huge difference in this game. I think it's going to be I think it's going to be a surprise to these Texans. I think they're on their defense played extremely well against the 49ers, even though they were, you're missing a few weapons there when they were playing them. I think the Vikings come out and they get this little upset.
I love it. We're going to lock it in. We're taking the Vikings plus two. I'm just trying to pull it up real quick on DraftKings and see what this is at. 1.5 or two. We'll give it at two. I see on the ESPN spread, they got it at two. So I'm sure you guys can find it hopefully somewhere. Give us the Vikings plus two as Mr. Deegan's first play of the day. All right. Play number two. We're looking at the Los Angeles Chargers, 2-0 on the year also. Taking on the also undefeated Pittsburgh Steelers. This game's also 12 o'clock Central Time on CBS. This one opened up, it looks like at -2.5, Pittsburgh's favor. I'm seeing it now around -3. And it looks like you got this at an even better line, though. I'll let you break it down, Mr. Deegan.
I got -1.5 here on most of these books that I see, but -3, that's a very small play if that's what it is, honestly. I got the spread as -4 on my true spread at least. I have not been impressed with the Chargers offense. Their defenses look nice. But truthfully, if you watch that game against the Panthers, if they played in a team that didn't have Bryce Young at quarterback, that game either would have been super close, or they would have lost it. They had some key turnovers at midfield early that any other team, including this Steelers team that is whose offense is not that great either, would have at least turned into field goals. While I don't think the Panthers had a first down, and I think they had one first down at the end of the first half, and I don't even know how many in the second. They barely had any. And against the Raiders, they also didn't impress me on offense. Their defense has been playing well, but I think the Steelers defense, which is probably a top three defense, I think they're going to create some key turnovers here. I think they're going to cause some mayhem. If they get these turnovers that these other two teams have been getting, they're going to turn them into points. And we've already seen Pittsburgh win a game off just field goals. I mean, their defense is that good that they can win a game off just field goals. I think they control this game defensively. I think it's a low scoring game, and I think they edge out the win here against the Chargers. Also, the Chargers have been traveling two games straight, completely on the other side of the country. I think that's going to wear them down a little bit.
Lock it in. We're taking the Steelers -1.5 officially as Mr. Deegan's second play. Play number two, we're look or three, I'm sorry. We're looking at the Detroit Lions, who are 1-1, taking on the Cardinals, who are 1-1, 3:25 Central Time. And the spread that we got this at is the Lions -3. Break it down what you like in this game.
Yeah, so I went against the Lions last week on the spread. Honestly, if you watch that game, they probably should have still covered that spread and won that game. They made, I think, seven red zone trips and came away with no points at all. I don't think that's going to happen again. Arizona looked really nice, but they were playing against a really hurt. I mean, Cooper Kupp went out. I mean, the Rams are just kind of injury wise going, it's pretty bad over there for the Rams. I liked what I saw from Arizona, but Detroit's probably the most complete team in the league. One of them, both offensive and defensively, they're just all around a great team. Dan Campbell has been the most profitable coach to bet on against the spread since he's been the coach of the Lions. I think they get back on track here in Arizona. I think on offense, at least, that they're not going to have those red zone trips turn up with 0 points. I also see their defense being able to slow down Kyler Murray and this entire offense they got going down there. Like I said, I like what I see. It's a small play for me because my spread is my number matches what the books are given. This is just a personal what I've seen from both teams and what I know. I just think the Lions come out and edge out this win.
Lock it in. We're taking the Lions -3 as Mr. Deegan's third play. And the fourth and final play now, we're looking at the Philadelphia Eagles 1-1 on the year, taking on the New Orleans Saints 2-0, 12 o'clock Central on Fox. And Mr. Deegan got this as the Saints -2.5. I'm still seeing that on a lot of the books. What are your thoughts on this bad boy?
So the Saints are probably one of the nicest surprises this year so far. I think you had them last week, LB, against Dallas. They have 40 points each game. They're coming in and rolling in heavy. From what we see from the Eagles, they have been, at least through these 2 weeks, one of the worst rush defenses in the league so far. They've been getting ran all over. I think we're going to see Kamara have a big day. You got the Eagles coming off a short week also, playing on Monday night, and I think that loss is also going to kind of sting over into this week because, let's be honest, they shouldn't have lost that game. That's a brutal way to lose that game. I think they're going to still be without AJ Brown, and the Saints defense has been playing extremely well also. I just think this short week, this short turnaround with the Saints just on a roll right now and the Eagles kind of on a downward trend, I think it just continues into Sunday.
Lock it in. We're taking the Saints minus 2.5 as Mr. Deegan's fourth and final play. All right, we will now transition on to LB. He's got three plays. And as I said, if he sweeps, we will do a $20 giveaway. The first one is a player prop here. We're looking at the Chicago Bears, 1-1 on the year, taking on the Indianapolis Colts, 0-2. And we are looking at Mr. Anthony Richardson. Along with Josh Downs, I believe this is a same game parlay. I'll let you break it down from here, LB.
Yep. Was just looking to get some plus money on some alternate lines here. The coaches have been talking about Anthony Richardson getting some featured running plays. Books kind of adjusted and took his rushing line up to 39.5. So without taking too much, close to that, going to look for his rushing yards to be right around 25, just to clear this through. And then his favorite target from last year is coming back. He does present a matchup problem for the Bears. It's Josh Downs. He's got a very low passing line as well, just because, Richardson can spread the ball around, not to any specific target. So as Downs coming back, he's definitely one of those deep threats, but he's also a volume guy that gets underneath the defense. So we alter him to 25 yards to get a plus money play out of this. Should be able to do this on most books. It got me plus 114 on this one.
Lock it in. We're taking Anthony Richardson 25 plus rushing yards combined with Josh Downs 25 plus receiving yards. Those are both alternate lines, combining them with as a same game parlay at plus money. That'll be the first play for LB. All right, play number two. We're looking at the Carolina Panthers 0-2, taking on the Las Vegas Raiders 1-1. 3:05 Central Time on CBS. What we're looking at here is going to be Andy Dalton. 33.5, the longest pass for him. Over or under, tell us what your thoughts are on this one.
Right, we're just picking on this Panthers team until they show us something different here. Andy Dalton takes over to bench Bryce Young, who's headed who knows where now, but the team is kind of in disarray. Plugging back in Andy Dalton, who's obviously a viable veteran, but where are they going to move the ball? The longest pass for Bryce Young was just about 30 yards, and when they bumped this line to 33.5, I just don't see the deep threats happening for Dalton. Dump offs perhaps, but the defense they're going against is still going to get them trouble moving the football. So this is a good spot to take just Dalton's longest pass, not going past 33.5. I would also consider possibly taking the under on his passing attempts overall, just because of the way the offense is. But either way, under 33.5 for the longest completion.
I love it. Lock it in. I'm taking Dalton under 33.5 for his longest pass as his second play. And LB gave us a little bit of a bonus play there as well. Our third and final play now, we're looking at the San Francisco 49ers, 1-1 on the year, taking on the Los Angeles Rams, who are 0-2, 3:25 Central Time on Fox. We're looking at the over-under on this one, 43.5. Break it down what we are on.
Yeah, we might be ahead of this number. Some more news came out. Definitely, Tough is going to be ruled out. Nacua is already out. Where are the points going to come from? Both teams are not dynamic offensively right now, with key losses to with injuries. So I think the books have responded and given us a low number that we can slide under. It seems as if we should be paying attention to the movement on this. Just based off of what we've seen. So I feel like this is the right spot to find this for this particular game with the lack of offense on both sides. It really made sense to get this at even money here.
Lock it in. We're taking under 43.5, and I'm still even seeing this at 43 at the worst on DraftKings. So you guys should be able to get it at a good number. That'll be LB's third and final play under 43.5 in the Niners Rams game. That's going to wrap it up for us today, giving you guys seven plays from our two cappers. And reminder, if you'd like to qualify for the giveaway, number one, subscribe to the channel. Number two, comment below 3-0 or 4-0. Then number three, like the video. If either of our guys sweeps, I will do another giveaway on next week's show. Our motto on the show is to bust your bookie. We did have a good day last week. Let's keep things rolling. Let's get the 7-0 sweep this week in week three in the NFL.